Hi students, I'm going to explain Python program to blink an LED without Adafruit library. So in this program, first we'll discuss the steps. So first step is to import first then time library. Then step 2, we'll define variable for pin number, and then we have to define variable for sysfs path. So what is sysfs path? So this path is called as sysfs path, that is /sys/class/gpi. So that path, which is having the gpi or directories and gpi related files, that path is called as sysfs path. So in step 3, we are defining a function to write export file, because now we have to write the export file because we have to create the directories and files related with the pin. In step 4, we are defining a function to write an export file. So here we will write an export file to delete all the directories and files related with that pin. So in step 5, we have to define a function to write direction file, so which will be available in this GPIO. N means that stands for that will replace with the number of that GPIO, and which will have the direction file that we have to write for making in and out mode. Then in step 6, we have defined a function to write value file, where we will use this path and will write the value file with 0 and 1. After that, in step 7, we'll define a function to initialize an LED. In step 8, we'll define a function to uninitialize an LED. In step 9, we'll define a function to make LED on and off. And in step 10, we'll call these functions from main program. Okay, we'll start the program writing. So we are, so blink, here will give the name, then after that we first use the shibai character. So this we use, then first we will import the libraries. So we have to import sys and then time library. So after that we will define variable for pin. So let's see, we consider one of the variable, one of the pin number. So just see the pin number. So use east red LED, that is LED 10, that is this 27. Okay, so east red I will use. Okay, so I'm using the traffic light simulation board on which there is a red LED, east red LED, which is having a one number 27. So after calculating Linux serial name, it gives 27 the number. So I will use LED, which is equal to free packet 27. So this makes, we can call this formula, that is 0 into 32 plus 27. So after that we have defined a variable for, this is for pin, and then sysfs path. So we write sysfs p, we'll just write path here, and then we'll give the path /sys/class/gpio. So this is the path that is called as sysfs path. The next step is to define a function, for export and unexport. Okay, so def gp export, which will take the parameter LED. So because it requires the pin number. So here I will use just F and I will use open system call. What is, that is the member of this library. So open, then we will use the path name, that is path, then plus what I have to open, that is export, that I will give here. And after that, which node you have to open it in writing mode. Okay, so that path node I will provide, that is that node I will use here, or flag I will use here in open system call. So this will be your path, and after this will be your the mode, that is write mode you will use here, because you write that file. So for me, I will use F object and I will write this file. Okay, so I will call write system call, and then I will pass this LED as a parameter, and then after that I will show the file with the input close system call. So this way, same will be the unexport function. So I'll just copy this data and I will paste here. So for unexport, that will be just change. I want to change it, we have to change the function name. And after that, this we have to replace with unexport. What will anything will be same here. Again, in next step, we will define function for writing direction and value file. Okay, so we will define function for direction and value file writing. So this set DRR and use. So for this function, we need the bin number. And after that, its mode or its direction. So for that, I will use the name, the variable in DIR. And then in this function, the definition will be same again. So I will just copy and I will paste here, because you have to open that file here, and then you have to write that file and you have to close it. So you have to change it. We just make change that in this path we'll go GPIO directory. Again, after that we'll in GPIO directory. Again, we have to go for GPIO 27. So here we have an LED which will have the 27 number, so that we have to provide. And again, find that to for direction file. So this way we are accessing the path for path, that is slash sys slash class slash GPIO slash GPIO 27 slash direction. So that's here we have to change LED with DIR, the mode. So next function is for set value. So which will have the only which will have the LED, the pin number, for that we have the val parameter for providing the value 0 or 1. So here the definition will be same. I will just copy and paste here. Now again, we will go to the new path, that is slash sys slash class slash GPIO slash GPIO 27 slash value. So I will just change here, replace this with value, and here just I will change with that, because then we have the 0 and 1 value. So now the next step is to define function for initializing and uninitializing. LED. Okay, so I will use def init LED, will use the name, and inside this function will call first the export function. So I will just call gp export function here, then I will call, so which will have LED. After that, we will call GP, that is set, sorry, set the error function here, which will have LED, and it will have VRR equal to out. So now we have to set the action out here. So that the set the error is called here and it is passed with the out parameter. Here, to that, we have to set the value, the value is closed here, and we will set the value 0 here, which will be off. So this will be in the LED function is defined. Now for running it, on init, or I will just replace it with exit LED function name. Which will, in this function definition, will first off the LED. This way you can turn off the LED. And then after that we will call GP unexport function for editing all the directories. Which are going to do that. Now, the task has been completed. Now the next is that we have to call all these functions. Now we will define functions for LED on and LED off. So we will define function for LED on. So this function will just call a set value, where we'll have the LED and we'll have the var equal to 1, because we have to write 1 on value 5. And the second function will be LED off, which will have again the call of set value, which will have LED pin number, and that is var equal to 0. So here we'll turn off LED, we'll write the 0 on value 5. After that we will call from main program, which will call these functions from main program. So before that we print, also we will use while 2 here, but before while 2 we will call init led function. Okay, and then after that inside while 2 we will first print LED is on, and after that we'll call LED on function here, and then we'll provide time over sleep of 1 second, and after that again we'll display LED off, and again we'll call LED off function here. Then we provide sleep time 1 second, and then after this for handling the exception we'll make it, or we'll put it into the try and exception block. So see, here in the except block, we provide keyboard interrupt the exception name, and then there will be a keyboard interrupt. It will do what? It will unexport the LED, so it will call GP unexport, and then it will use exit. So this way we can define a program, we can write a program, Python program, to blink LED. So here we need not to use Adafruit library. Without Adafruit we can also write a program for blinking LED. So now I can select it. So after that we'll run it. So before that, I will take it here. just put it here. The number is 168.43. See, we'll get the picture here and how the array is going to run and out. You can see that the top right regular is blinking. This way we can blink an LED using Python program but without Adafruit library, and close it. And then, thank you for watching this video.